in the university's Innovation Village. From the 3-yard line. Knocked out of bounds around the 26-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Tackled after positive yardage. Makes it out to about the 40.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Catch on that one. He's tackled at the 50. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. From the 50, it's second down. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. The Owls always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. Bring him down at about the 43-yard line. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Owls have a new head man, new theories, new hopes, new dreams. Will there be new wins? We'll find out. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And a quick throw, brought down at the 32-yard line.
And that is a great call and a big gain, especially on an early down.
It's first and 10, ball on the 32-yard line. Play action. He's taken down around the 45-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
Makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. From the 43-yard line, second down. Jackson takes it right side. And he's tackled
at about the 27-yard line.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
First and 10, ball on the 27. They'll go Brown. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Flips it middle to the running back, and he's taken down at the 19-yard line.
That'll bring up third and 2.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Simmons on the run. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short. Made at the 8-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards.
That makes it first down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He's got it out to his tight end, and they make the stop at the 3-yard line.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings up second and goal.
10th play of the drive. Looks to the end zone, and it's caught. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 81-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 7-0. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Houston's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. They'll work the right side, and there's nothing going there.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. The Cougars with a touchdown lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. He scrambled. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
It's now third down and long. 13 yards to go for the first down after the sack.
Watch 85. Ball's going 85. Watch 85.
Three. He's wrapped up for the sack.
That is a loss of 10 yards. That makes it fourth and long.
Morris is waiting for the snap. Williams
takes it at the 45,
and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Houston is up 7. Hands off up the middle and stuffed. Second and 12. Ball on the 34-yard line. He goes out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Caught out in the open. And down he goes around the 15-yard line.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Dumps it complete, the tight end over the middle. He's tackled around the 5-yard line.
Gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. This one is incomplete. Houston up 7 points. And he is drilled at the 5.
No gain on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Hoping to double their lead here as they close in on the goal line. They'll bring him down at the 2. Houston's going to use their first time out of the half here. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Touchdown, Houston! The extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 1. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 24-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down around the 24-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. He gets sacked on the play.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, But it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
Houston's called their final timeout. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Williams takes it at the 49. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Mixon's the kind of guy, Kirk, that I'm sure still wants to get the football here before halftime.
Well, he's a back that seems like the more touches he gets, the better he gets. So I think it's a matter of him finding his rhythm. But luckily for him, the passing game has been able to pick up some of the slack.
Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. Hall's the kind of impact player that every team in the country would love to have on their team. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds. Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big game.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice gain for the offense.
From the 12-yard line, first down. He makes it to the 9.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Get in the way, Luke. Get in the way, Luke.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. There's a strike complete. Touchdown, Cougars. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
He makes the PAT. McCarthy is lined up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
From their own 35-yard line, first down. The 39-yard line.
Yeah, I think he's got a good rhythm going right now with his wide receivers. He hit him for a nice game.
Now he's scrambling. And he's tackled at about the 47-yard line. Florida Atlantic will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. We've got a first and 10, ball on 34.
Check 26, check 26. Let's go.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Looks middle, got his back. Taken down around the 34-yard line.
excellent open field tackle. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. The Cougars with a 3-touchdown advantage.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Gathered in at the six. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Now, they practiced all week this week, and they told us yesterday, Brad, that they felt pretty good about what they put in, the plan that they had. And I think now that you see them playing today, it's no wonder they felt so good.
This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys. Makes it to the 34.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to know. They don't want to know.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Tackle made at the 46.
Gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Ready. Ready.
Quick out to his receiver. And they make the stop at about the 49.
That brings him second and five.
Second down and five. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's at the 40, and he hauls that one in. Tackle at about the 35.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
Hey, check, check. Mike 50. Here we go. Set. Line 80. Check, check. Thunder.
Fires it out, and down he goes at the 28-yard line.
Gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. Tackle there in space.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. First down.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Nice run there. Mixon gains around 6 yards on the run.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver and maybe every other member of this offense. The wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Zips it to the back, and he's leveled at the 5-yard line. Gain of 7 on the play. First and goal from the 4, looking for Pater. Hits him hard at the 4-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
If it's any consolation, he did pick up some positive yards, but I doubt that's enough to make him forget the hit that he just took.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. And he stopped behind the line. Here we go, folks. 3rd and goal from the 4. It's power against power right now on the field. Both teams have their jumbo sets out there. Oh, it almost picked off.
The defense had a chance here, Brad, to just end the drive. An interception there. They get the football back and a lot of momentum.
Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. McCarthy ready to kick. He's to the 20. Houston's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Scrambling around. Now he's going to run, and watch out. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line. Chucked out of bounds around the 47-yard line. He flings it right. Going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He fights forward to about the 49. Harris picks up 2 yards with a carry. Morris is waiting for the snap. He makes it out to about the 27-yard line. We head to the 4th. 24-0, Houston. We're just about set to start action here again in the 4th quarter. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on 2nd down.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Brought down right around the 34. Taken down at the 39.
Gain of 5 yards. First down.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down.
Watch the run.
Mike's 50. Mike's
ready.
50.
Wide 80. Wide.
Complete. He's got room. He's at midfield. He's knocked out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down.
Man left.
From the 43-yard line, first down.
Ready.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Brings him second and five.
I got double tight. Four down. Mike's 50.
Let's go. Gray 95.
He zips it, and it's picked off.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 14-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Let's go. Here we got Mike.
Throws complete. He's hit right away. Quick throw out to the receiver, and he's tackled at the 25. Under pressure. He's got it with room to run. And he is drilled at the 34.
Brown makes the tackle at the 34-yard line.
Man left.
That brings up second and one.
Three down. Let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53.
Check 26. Gets it. He's in space. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds. Right around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
From their own 42-yard line. Second down. Just under two to go in the game. He's hit and taken down.
That's good.
Sanchez, the intended receiver on the play.
10th play of the drive. Tackles him hard at the 44.
That's a that makes it
just a minute nice. Remains in this football game. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense. And look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He steps out at the 37.
That'll bring up second and three.
And this is the 14th play of the drive. Let's it go.
They didn't sack him. The pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. We have less than a minute to go. Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. And they push him out around the 27-yard line. And this is the 16th play of the drive. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Caught with room to work. Tackle made around the 17-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From the 17-yard line, first down. He's hit immediately.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Owls. A short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the 2-point conversion.
In your face.
And it's caught for 2. Down he goes, the 39-yard line. I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Florida Atlantic will take their last time out. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, Houston 24, Florida Atlantic 8. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.